Tonight, crews are working to remove what Hurricane Ian pushed into our waters more than 5 months ago.
Pretty much anything that could float away could be in these waters.
From the bays in Naples to the Peace River off Punta Gorda.
I walk here every morning and, I see all these boats and it's very sad.
They'll go away eventually.
It was incredible. You don't realize the power of water till you see what has happened.
We're showing you the efforts to prevent an environmental disaster in our waterways.
Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Naples police tell us at least 60 cars were likely washed into our waterways during Hurricane Ian. NBC2's Ryan Arbogast is live and local at Venetian Bay in Naples, where crews are lifting those sunken cars to the surface.
Peter, Naples police tell us 3 out of the 5 cars they know about right now have been brought to the surface. I want to show you them. If you take a look to my left, that is a barge with those 3 very cars off of Moorings Bay. You can see the cars have been completely decomposed and you can barely identify them. They've been under the water for 6 months, and that length of time has some water activists concerned about pollution.
If we have, let's say, 10 cars still unaccounted for, imagine how much additional pollution is being put into the water, especially if there's any leakage.
Collier County waterkeeper Shelley McKernan tells us that 1 quart of oil can contaminate more than 1 million gallons of water. The pollution only gets worse the longer the cars sit underwater and break down.
Leaving a car in the water for a period of time will have corrosion and will create all sorts of leaks within the car from fuel, oil, any other fluid that would be in the car.
Our crews caught a state contractor removing the 3 vehicles you saw from Venetian Bay on Monday afternoon. This formerly red Chevy was reported by Donna Stricker all the way back in January. It sat along the docks near the shops at Venetian Village for nearly 6 months.
You hate anything to pollute the water, and red tide is terrible, but then you don't need extra gas and debris and who knows what's still left after the hurricanes.
Naples police tell us more than 60 vehicles are still considered unaccounted for. The remaining 2 that are buoyed are located in the moorings.
Is this really happening again? Are we not addressing a water quality issue again? Are we not addressing our pollution again? Are we not following up with anything again?
Now, we don't know if the state contractor has found any of those other 60-plus unaccounted-for vehicles. However, they did tell us they plan on using sonar technology to find the boats that are hidden and the cars under the water. I'm reporting live and local in Naples tonight. Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.